Hello, there it is. Yaha, I'm back at the news desk. Maybe back at this particular version of this newsroom for the last time. We'll see. I put these on backwards. I might have, whatever. Good to see everybody. I'm back on my news grind. I fell off the news wagon. Back on it. Haven't looked at any news. Why? Because you know the name of the thing. You get it. Hope everybody's doing well. Good to see Jay Money. Good to see Live and Sleazy. Are these backwards? They are backwards. I'm going to switch these around. Haha. I'm so unused to doing the news now. Might have a haircut tomorrow. Everything will change in 18 subs. Good to see S1000, Skymer, John, Michael, Bundle Sprout. Alaskan Polar Bear, OG. Oh my gosh, Doofus Knife? Microphone 900 dropping 750 bits already.
Me. I love it.
Ha, I'm, I won't tell anybody. I don't even read it, Microphone. But just know that I see it and I appreciate it. My favorite from the Cream Team? Probably Cassim's cat, if that counts. I met that thing. Is it morally righteous to pay to get the cutest cat? Yes, it turns out. Cassim was right. You get what you pay for. Some cats are worth more than others. I do think I would be tempted to get a breed like Cassim's cat, but I think I'd have to adopt. I think I can't buy the Mercedes-Benz of cats, even though it's tempting after meeting it. Plopdum's good to see a Bundle Sprout. Junk Dog, Gearless Joe, Nomad. Some names are just so fun to read. All of your names I love to read, but Junk Dog, Gearless Joe Nomad, that's a fun one to read. What's going on in the world today? I don't know. Capcom trying to increase game prices? CIA building their own artificial intelligence? Ooh. Maybe I should bring on AI Rooney for once. He's kind of my expert in technology. I meant to stream a lot earlier today, but my camera that I used to bring in my other valued news team members broke entirely. I had to completely remake it. So we'll see if I can even load AI Rooney. Let's see. CIA. Oh, can I not read this? Come on. Let me read Bloomberg News. I want your sweet, sweet news. Well, I bet they're not the only ones covering this. Oh yeah, let's see if we got any subs before I started today. We have a call for an expert, a tutorial. Wait, tutorial or use the internet threads? Wait, I don't know what that means. Yeah, baby,
give me your sweet videos.
You just want a tutorial on how to use the internet? Or do I need, I probably need a tutorial on how to use the internet. Jesus Christ, Stevie loves you, fucking hammering me with subs. Incredible right away. Okay, wait. We had Celotortoise resubscribing for 6 months, right when we started the stream. In the pre-stream, Commander Geb, thank you so much for the resubscription as well. 9 months. Guys, we're going to hit a year soon. That means I got to update these farmers. Oh my God. So just a little disclosure. When we hit this goal, which it seems like now we might, that means tomorrow, boom, full new, beautiful. I'm bringing in the work when I'm saying work overnight. Tomorrow, it's gonna look different in here. The workman is 88 Kyles per hour. He's the construction lead on this. Anyway, Enta Daddy, thank you so much for the 5 subs. CV loves you, as always. Thank you for raining out the 5 community gifted subs. Skymer cheersing for 100 bits. And just like that, it's here. It's here. Maybe you thought you escaped it. There is no escape. It's like a one-winged angel from Kenny Omega, guys. There's no... Oh, it's the wrong one. That's the wrong one. That's the right one. There's no escaping this hype train. Let's see with my Snapchat difficulties if I have escaped the hype train, though. Hype train, are you there? Excuse me, Mr. Train. Mr. Train? Turn you up. Are you, in fact, with us? Mr. Hype Train? Hello?
Keep
on with your dumb ass. I never fucking left. I'm fucking here. I'm the fucking... You know who it fucking is, baby. It's the fucking Hype Train.
There's no escape. You come back, you fucking deal with me. Hype Train, returning.
I'm just gonna assume this is what the people want to see, and I'm gonna first thing, stick around with you for a minute, Hype Train. I mean, you got 2 minutes left before you're sucked of all your hype.
Suck my hype out. Fuck me till all my hype is gone.
Is that how that works? The hype gets sucked out of you? I thought it got pushed into you.
Either way, the hype gets pushed in. The hype gets sucked.
Yeah, baby! Okay. Is this loud as this music gets? If I want to get the music loud enough to drown you out, Hype Train.
There's no drowning me out. I'm too busy being hype. Thank you so much. CD loves you. Yum, 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 yum. See, you push the hype in, and then another thing sucks it out.
What sucks the hype out?
Just life, man. You know, life. It creeps up on you, and it sucks out your hype. Straight out of your hype hole. But not when you push it in. You push the hype in, and then it takes a minute for it to get sucked right out. And that's how it works!
You've given me so many explanations for how your hype works. You claim to poop out hype, and that's what's all around you?
That's after it gets sucked out. It's poop.
Stevie loves you. Thank you so much for the sub. And to Daddy, once again, thank you for the subs. No need to hype this train too much. I totally understand if you want it.
Where's my fucking songs? Give me a new song. Give me an 8-bit remix of Quad City DJs. That's what I want. I want an 8-bit remix right now.
Is this even what I asked for?
I don't know, probably. Is this it?
Oh yeah, baby, give me your sweet bitties deep inside me. I love it, I love it.
Dance, you bitch!
What?
Dance, you bitch!
Don't call me that, that's... Don't use that word, hype train.
Fuck you, dance, bitch! Now, harder! Harder, you bitch! I said dance hard, bitch!
Stop calling me that!
You're not dancing. You're not dancing hard enough. Fucking help me out, bitch!
Something like... My new nickname can't be bitch. You know what? I don't even take offense to that. Rappers have desensitized to it. Your music is so loud, Hype Train.
It's not loud enough!
This is an 8-bit remix of Space Jam. It's not even Quad City. It's not the right Quad Cities track.
Let's ride that train, Quad City. Come on, ride it.
Is this not the song you want?
This isn't. This is pretty good. So dance. Bitch.
Yeah? That doing it for you?
Take off your fucking coat.
No.
Take it off. Take it off and dance.
I'm not doing that for you. You're going to like the Mortal Kombat registry today, Hype Train.
Mortal Kombat!
This is
the Mortal Kombat remix of Space Jam. Mortal Kombat! Mortal Kombat! Mortal Kombat! Toasty! Mortal Kombat! Toasty!
Let me see if I can find the other Quad City DJ song. And also, you need to help me out with these subs. You're missing all of them, Hype Train.
Thank you to the Scanner for gifting the tier one Lord Servo. One community sub gift. Oh, it feels so good. It's pushing hype into me that you then get to suck right out. And Stevie loves you. Thank you so much for the gifted tier one month. Wow.
Okay. Let's see. See if we can find a train version of this. Alright, I think we did. This is a little remix happening live. Okay, is this more what you're looking for?
Oh, this is what I wanted. Skymer, thank you so much. Thank you for giving me another tier one sub. And it's going to the Quad City DJs.
Why are you always so horny sounding?
This music gets me fucking going, baby. Oh, yeah, it's got the word train in it. Do you get it?
Yeah, I understand that it has the word train in it, Hype Train. Okay, look, the hype train's over. It's been over for 3 minutes, actually. I don't know how you're still going.
I'm out of hype? What? Oh, I can feel it getting sucked out of me right now. Oh!
Ignore that. Okay. And we're back. Wait a minute, why did that graphic open up? Makes it seem like I'm saying I'm a doctor. That's we already talked about. That's our last news story. I'm sorry, everyone. I'm not a doctor and I don't know how to make you come harder. Well, I guess let's learn about the CIA building its own artificial intelligence. Now that we've displayed our intelligence for the day via the hype train, I guess let's discuss some news. There was a request from Live and Sleazy. Okay, I gotta find it. And Live and Sleazy, I'm sorry, I missed your explanation of this. Tutorial or use the internet threads? I just don't... If you can enlighten me as to what use the internet threads means. Is that like a thing? The internet threads? Did we do the Mexican aliens? We kind of talked about that on the Patreon, which a lot of you probably... Well, some of you might not have seen. We're talking about Russell Brand. You know, I'll be honest. As much as I love our dear boy Clementine Vern, some of the things Mr. Brand has been up to have made me less excited to kick it to someone that some people say looks so much like him. So I don't know. We might just have to see what we do with Mr. Vern. Not that you can't make fun of people who do awful things, but a regular character that looks so much like Russell Brand might bum me out. But you know, we should let Clementine at least say goodbye if I'm kicking him off the team, which is what I'm considering doing. I guess you could just get a haircut and change his accent. That's always an option. You know, maybe he gets a haircut and suddenly he claims he's not from a particular place. So maybe his accent just changes and he gets a haircut, but he keeps the name. An interview with Russell and Joe Rogan. You know, I guess technically, is that doable? Yeah, and that probably is. I have to set it up. I guess he could be Australian. If that's an accent he can... I mean, not that he's pulling off any accent in particular, honestly. Are there any other big conspiracy guys that aren't Russell Brand? Oh, yeah, or lean hard into the conspiracy alt-right misogyny, yeah. I mean, I think I should let Clementine at least probably say his piece about it. But maybe we'll save that for a little later in the stream. Okay. Use the internet threads. Live and Sleazy, if you can just enlighten me as to what your request means, I will 1,000% pay it off for you. And I don't see you already replied to me. But you might have. Anywho, for now, while that's a brewing, I guess when I'm off, that means the rest of my news team is off. And that means Chet hasn't worked in a while. And, you know, he might be mad about it. I fucking mad, dude. I'm still clocking these hours. I showed up to work and you getting that invoice. You actually, your salary. What? Yeah, you don't. Your salary, dude. You don't have to invoice me. There are two threads on the Discord and use the internet, pick a story. Oh, use the internet. That makes fucking sense. Okay. Where are my beautiful threads? Show me the threads. Come on, back feed. Oh my God. I need a tutorial on how to use the internet. Okay, there it is. Yeah. Oh my gosh. I haven't looked at this thread in way too long. Jump to the present. Whoa, it refuses to jump me to the present. Okay, there it is. I don't know what some of these are, but we'll look at some of them. Chet, you want to look at the internet with me? That's what I thought we did every time, dude. Yeah, like I said, it's kind of just all we do. So yeah, I mean, just bring me on. Well, I don't even talk about the fucking CIA. I refuse to believe in the existence of the CIA. I think that's the real conspiracy theory. Chet, that's not a very logical one. It definitely exists as an institution. Prove it. I've driven by, you know, I'm from Northern Virginia nearly. Well, I'm from Southwest Virginia, but I've been to Northern Virginia. It's a place, I swear. Langley is in the mind. Well, look, so we're trying to use the internet today and look at TikToks, essentially. Okay, well, then I'm coming over. All right, that's fine. Please welcome to the jet. Sorry, the desk. Chat. Learn to fucking speak, dude. It's ain't a jet, it's a desk. And that's the thing I know, so what's your excuse? Okay, it's good to see you, Chet. Good to see you. Okay. Chet needs to meet Leon. Kennedy? See, I think he's a Secret Service agent, and thus I believe in his existence. Well, on this channel, he is also a CIA agent, we've claimed. I used to have a whole job where we don't even need to get into it. Yeah, whatever happened to your day job that you claimed was at the CIA? Have they just been in that castle for months waiting for your orders? Let's use the internet and see what's on there. Let's just fucking show the Discord, baby, full screen. I mean, I'm happy to dox your shit, always. Mickey Rourke on US. Okay, this is my kind of thing.
But I'm not going to go into it because I don't need another shit. Visit from the Secret Service.
It's so little. Wait, okay, let me try this way.
When did you have one before?
Okay, wait.
About 6 months.
I'm going to do this better. I'm going to fix your system, Case. The system is broken. That's probably what Mickey Rourke is saying. More importantly, the way Case is viewing these videos is fucking ridiculous. But anyway, here we go. I can find it bigger.
The Secret Service. Right. But I'm not going to go into it because I don't need another visit from the Secret Service.
When did you have one before?
Oh, about 6 months ago.
Why?
Take a wild guess.
Was it because of something you said about President Trump?
Yeah.
What did you say about him?
Just the truth.
Which is what?
Read my mind. But I'm not going to go into it.
Wait, what? He was leading me down a mental maze, and I was not following him. First, he's like, read my mind, like, guess. Like, why would Trump be tracking what Mickey Rourke is saying about him?
Take a wild guess.
Like, my wild guess would be like, were you cockfighting? Were you raising were you doing various forms of animal fighting? That would be my immediate guess. Why is that your immediate guess? I don't know. Just look at Mickey Rourke. Like, the thing that jumps to mind isn't the president is tracking Mickey Rourke's opinions and will sick the Secret Service on him. I mean, maybe you're just unfamiliar with the deep political thoughts of Mickey Rourke. Oh, also, I missed some subs. Microphone 900, thank you again. Oh, that's way down. Okay, Reverie Wolf, thank you for the 11 months. Guys, we're approaching the year mark. So many of us. A year of streaming. And what a year it's been. I mean, it's been pretty good ever since I started. You used to just be kind of a fucking dumbass sitting in a room. And now you're a team of smartasses. There you go. Smartasses. That's the opposite of a dumbass. I just thought of that. So that's a very common phrase, smartass. I pretty much just discovered in the moment that you could have that the opposite of a dumbass is a smartass. And also, I'd like to point out that courtesy of the support, CV loves you, Reverie Wolf, the whole fucking squad. Boom, dude, get the fucking look at my oh my god, my football injuries. Oh god, look at these hands. It's so hard to point with them. Let me straighten them out. The point of this. Ow! Oh, they're so fucked up. Anyway, we did it. I gotta not point as much. My doctor said I need to stop pointing so aggressively because my hands are just fucked from football. But I'm excited. Whole new studio on the way. That's true. Brand new studio in the mix coming down the line. Oh, sorry, I'm just gonna sit up really quick. There we go. I feel better. You've been slumped over in your chair like hella slumped, dude. A little bit. Anyway, a brand new studio upgrade coming courtesy of you guys. Thank you so much for the endless fucking support. Our top contributor, CV loves you. Tam Tran, Enta Daddy, Street Marine, I worship Shadow, but more importantly, everyone. Well, equally importantly. Thank you so much. We'll see. I think Kyle's gonna do a good job. He always does. Anywho, we was talking about Mickey Rourke before. I just kind of lost what I was tracking about it. But basically, I guess the Secret Service is fucking after his ass. Leon Kennedy himself kicking down Mr. Rourke's door, saying, show me them hands. What you saying about President Trump? This is, I'd like to point out, from recently. Wait, the post is from recently. I don't know when. Is there a date on this? When did Mickey Rourke say this shit?
Is something you said about President Trump?
Yeah.
What did you say about him?
He looks like younger than he did in The Wrestler, but also older. He's somehow younger and older. I don't know what happened to his face. It looks like better and worse. So that's the power of a real superstar. Is your face can move in so many different directions. You're like, does he look better? Does he look worse than he's ever looked? I honestly don't know. Okay, look. Shit, can we even watch this? All right, this video is going to be real little. I don't think there's any way around that. Oh, I can download it. Okay, I'm going to download this video. Just a second. I'm doing important things. I'm having some technical issues, but I'm about to fix them. Okay. Whoa, 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 whoa. Stop it. Okay, now I show this to y'all. Check this shit out. It's a dude, he's doing fucking calisthenics or some shit. This looks wild. Come on. God damn. What the? Jesus. Is this a new Street Fighter DLC? What's happening? I need to see that again. This is the scary part. I'm surprised more people aren't looking at him. Like, there should be more. This should have all of everyone's attention. Let's be real. Like, these people walking off in the background. He's got most of the attention, but I think he's earned all of it with his extreme, I'm going to call it a calf workout. It's the cyberware from Cyberpunk. I mean, pretty much. He's fucking locked and ready to go. Look at this shit. This is like the energy whip from Cyberpunk. So people need to keep their distance. If you upset him, immediate fucking decapitation, I'm assuming. I think those are workout bands. And I think you're a band idiot. they Cyberpunk swords, basically. Cyberpunk energy whips. Okay. Well, that's two, but I guess, you know what? This thread is full of some good juice. Why don't we just look at a few more? I was going to. Okay. Whoa. All right. We're going to do two more. We're just going to do whatever's in here. Let's see. What? What's the first video? Oh, okay. That's her too. I wasn't sure if that was just she ripped this video. This second one's cooler. I mean, I get the first one's got a vibe to it, but I would hang out more with the second one. Yeah, the first one's a little, maybe like a little too, they're trying a little too hard. Yeah, I mean, that's what she's going for. But I'm saying the second one, this is my fucking kind of deal. It's kind of how I am. You know, that's sort of my vibe. What's sort of your vibe? Like, I'm just fun and, like, I do fun shit. It's sort of my vibe. You seem kind of angry a lot of the time, honestly, Chet. I'm one of the chillest fuckers around, you piece of shit. Okay. Yeah, man, I'm fucking chill as hell. God damn, let's watch one more of these.
Wow.
My dog. Okay, wait. I'm reading it before you can even see it. All right, let's see.
Wow. Wow.
going on?
Is this just a nice video?
Wow. Wow, wow, wow.
I'm waiting to be spat upon. I think maybe it's just nice.
Beautiful.
Wow, wow, wow.
Oh, I haven't seen this strong Northern Lights in a long time.
Wow. That was just so nice. Let's just see it one more time. Wow. Wow.
No.
Wow, no.
What's going on?
This is my natural reaction, sorry.
Wow.
Wow, wow, wow. Wow.
This is so beautiful. Oh, I haven't seen this strong Northern Lights in a long time.
And that's sort of my natural, that's just my natural reaction to how beautiful that was. Chet, you were clearly struggling to just repeat what the video was saying. I mean, man, I can't help it if I react the same way. It was your second time watching it. You just have no joy in your life, Mr. Blackwell. And that's on you. And frankly, I don't even want to talk about the CIA with you today, because I already had my fun. And that's all the news that the people care about today is what's going down on TikTok. Ah, my hands. Fuck, I got to stop gesturing with them so much. Oh, man. Do you see these bad boys? They are fucked up. Look at mine. Mine are normal. Mine are fucked up. You fucking bragging about how your hands are normal? Oh, look at my normal hands, Chet. Oh, look at... Oh, God. I'm just showing mine off. Just for comparison, if people need to see. Oh, do indeed have arthritis. I have the type of arthritis where your hand kind of just vibrates and bends as you move it around. Oh, it's not diabetes yet. Although I've been told that's in the works for me. I've been working on getting some diabetes, and my doctor says pretty soon I should have that coming in. Your doctor said you should have diabetes coming in soon? Yeah, I've been like working up to it, and pretty soon I'm going to have diabetes. That's no, he's probably telling you to avoid, cut down on sugars or something. I don't know. I mean, I got to drink a lot of Gatorade or I can't work out enough. How much Gatorade are you drinking? I'm told you're supposed to drink, what, like 3 gallons a day to stay hydrated? 3 gallons of Gatorade a day? Yeah, and I dump a little Kool-Aid mix into my Gatorade just to give it a little more flavor. Chet, stop it, man. That's... Phantom Spaceman, good to see you. I thought you were giving me... Don't get distracted by Phantom Spaceman. He's saying hi to me. He said hi to me. Don't put Kool-Aid in your Gatorade. It's already basically Kool-Aid. Don't fucking dull my shine, man. Just because I'm an innovator and I thought, you know, Gatorade's pretty good, but what if I dump fucking Kool-Aid into it? Sometimes I'll mix flavors. The other day I mixed kiwi and fruit punch. Is kiwi even a Kool-Aid flavor? Yeah, I mean, I just said it. Why would I lie? And then I mixed it with fruit punch in a blue, icy cool Gatorade. Oh, Chet, that sounds fucking horrific, man. Yeah, exactly. Strawberry kiwi, fruit punch, blue raspberry, ice cool Gatorade. That sounds illegal, man. You should stop that. Well, you need a lot of sodium in your blood to be a salty dog. And I've been called a salty dog. And I'm just trying to be like a chill-ass, cool-ass, salty dog. Chat, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about today, honestly. But thank you for being here. And with that, I will sign off. No, Chet, you don't need to sign off. I better go straight into the sign off that we all need me to say. And so the TikToks that were not considered by some to be news, in fact, at this point, were proven so to be by yours, of which is Chet. And though parting has never been of sorrowful to me, to sweetly do it is what I'm, the task at which I now wave adieu. And so aloha in some languages means both hello, and it, I think it also means Hawaii. And so at this point, I say Hawaii to all of you, and 5-0, I'll be back. And back to that is which where you were, Case, and that's Chet. We didn't talk about any news. Although Mickey Rourke was on a news show. So that might still count as a little bit of news. Okay. let's see what's going on with the CIA. You know, I got a whole army of correspondents. So I'll just cycle through them. I mean, why not? If Chet won't talk about the CIA with me, I know a certain lady that is technically our political expert. And so she's got to. It's her job. Okay, this is... CIA builds its own artificial intelligence. Okay. This story does not look very in-depth, but let's read it anyway. With our girl joining me at the desk right now. It's Liliana Brething-Schmidt. Whoa. You cut right to me. Just slamming straight to me. No little fun transition. That's fine. Good to be here. Hello to everybody. Case has been a little lazy boy, hasn't been working, so I haven't seen you all, but it's good to see everyone. And today we're talking about CIA, which is one of my favorite acronyms. It's one of the best ones. It's your favorite acronym? Yeah, Central Intelligence Agency. This is fun to say. It rolls off the tongue. Some of my favorite aging... What's that? Don't mouse my little words. Some of my favorite aging power daddies, in which I'm in. Deeply psychologically tormented relationships. They work there. I'm a... what's they call a CIA groupie. Ew, what? That's not a thing. I'm one of the few. You have to have a really high security clearance to even become a CIA groupie. But due to my relationships with some of the most decrepit skeletal power brokers in the country, that's my fetish and you can't shame it. I won't kink shame your fetish for decrepit men with money and influence. Yeah, I mean, that's just one of the sexiest things is old, just, you know, looking like they're passing through the veil of darkness as you loom over them and say, I'm soon to conquer your genitals, you aging monster. Feed me your power and influence. That's my kink. And no one can shame me for it. So anyway, I'm just saying I'm an expert in the CIA. You sound like it. So let's see. This story is very short, but the U.S. intelligence agencies are getting their own ChatGPT-style tool to sift through an avalanche of public information for clues. And if you know anything about ChatGPT, it's that it's trustworthy, and this is great news. The Central Intelligence Agency is preparing to roll out a feature akin to OpenAI Inc.'s now famous programs that will use artificial intelligence to give analysts better access to open-source intelligence. According to... Wait, what the fuck? The CIA Open Source Enterprise Division plans to provide intelligence agencies with its AI tool soon. We've gone from newspapers and radios to newspapers and television to newspapers and cable television to basic internet to big data, and it just keeps going. Randy Nixon, director of the division, said in an interview. We have to find... And let's just look up Randy Nixon really quick, because that's the kind of name that when I see it, mommy wants to take a little look. You know what I mean? I really don't know what you mean, Liliana. This seems like the work of the cigarette-smoking man to get rid of Fox Mulder. Oh, no, that's a daddy I can get behind. You know, you might not be alone there. He has a certain charm to him. I can see some people being into the smoking man from the X-Files. Indeed, he's a smoking man. Smoking. Somebody stop me from spying on all Americans using artificial intelligence. It's less fun when the mask quote ends that way, but okay. Anyway, let's take a look at Randy Nixon from the CIA. Oh yeah, look at this guy. Ooh. Hello, Daddy. Oh yes, this is exactly what I'm talking about. Used to be a little too vivacious and full of life for me. This is exactly my kink right here. Let's open up this real little photo of him and blow it way up. Oh, yeah. That's the sort of... That's just what does it for me. Just a man, real red, stuffed into a generic suit, a broken smile, weird fucking balding, and you don't know, just looks both puffy and sick. And you just know he's in, like, meetings where he just dictates the course of a lot of people's lives with very arbitrary decisions. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm getting excited just talking about it. Yeah, zoom and enhance indeed. Play me some fucking sexy music. Mommy wants some sexy time music. Oh, what the f- Hey, that's super loud, and that's DJ Newsic music. But this is how my heart feels when I see a guy like this. I'm like, yeah, daddy. I just want to put a pillow over his mouth and be like, can you breathe? Can you breathe? But I'm on top of him. I don't know if that sounds I don't know if that counts as a kink. It is. Okay, I'm just gonna stop the music. Anyway, I'm saying he looks good. And I like what he's putting out. And basically I'm trying to say nice. Mommy likey. Anywho. We have to find the needles in the needle field. This is what Randy Nixon is saying, who I just lost it after. It's part of a broader government campaign to harness the power of AI and compete with China, which is seeking to become the global leader in the field by 2030. And we've only got six little years about to catch up. As the US push dovetails with the intelligence community's struggle to process the vast amounts of data that's now publicly available amid criticism that it's been slow to exploit that source. The CIA's AI tool will allow users to see the original source of the, of the information they're viewing. He said that a chat feature is a logical part of getting intelligence distributed quicker. Then you can take it to the next level and start chatting and asking questions of the machines to give you answers. Also, source said Nixon, whose division oversees intelligence drawn from publicly and commercially available sources, which, to clarify, means your data. Just if you're confused about what's going on in this story, Randy Nixon. That's an important distinction. Yeah, sorry, I just got so turned on, I started thinking of Richard Nixon. Randy Nixon, what he's saying is, he is going to scrub all of your data, phone calls, emails, your web histories, and a very trustworthy ChatGPT clone is going to scrub that data for keywords, or maybe because it's a ChatGPT, it thinks that it understands context. Really, it probably doesn't. And it's going to then just sort of ping all of these government actors to then have to review all of your boring fucking data where you probably accidentally said, you know, Muhammad Akbar by accident during a sexting session. And they'll, then they'll, you know, that person will then dictate whether or not they send the fucking goof troop after you to fucking block, block, block. You know what I mean? Why didn't it follow that last part? You know, they'll send us, like, the fucking, they'll send, like, what's his fucking, like, the guy who played the wrestler? You mean what we just watched? With Mickey Rourke? Yeah, they'll send us a fucking Secret Service knocking on your door. Or the CIA. To me, they're interchangeable. On this channel, they are very interchangeable. And they'll just fucking, you know, if the AI decides it, they'll kick in your door. Block, block, block. Take you out like you were fucking terrorist in 2004. Okay? And it's an upgrade. Because, you know, before you needed a human to do that very boring logistical work of determining if, you know, the things that are being said by you in text and email and voice conversations are a threat to national security. Now we can fire all those fucking idiots and basically it's just a guy who will click yes or no, delete human. When the AI report comes to him. And I think that sounds like an efficiency to me. And I'm with my boy, Randy. Yummy. Whatever he wants, honestly. Daddy can get it. It sounds pretty bad. Well, you look pretty bad. Don't go all shit on me. You don't have to be mean. I'm sorry. Just don't fucking talk shit about my man. I'm sliding into these DMs. I'm just gonna say some like pretty wild shit in my DMs, and then I know eventually it will make its way to Randy. The AI will catch it. The CIA will kick in the door, but I'll be there in a negligee saying, send for Randy, please. And, you know, once they know it's me, they probably won't shoot me. And, everybody gets off, basically. But especially me. Yeah. Well, everything you said sounded psychotic, and I didn't even track all of it, but thank you for informing us that there's an AI that is going to oversee all of our data scrubbing. That's exciting. I'm sure there was already one kind of doing it, but maybe it was using keywords, and this one, who knows? They'll think it's stronger because of ChatGPT, I guess. And it will be strong like our boy Randy. And I guess I'll just I'm just gonna slide and I'm just gonna pop over and use Instagram for a bit in the corner. Excited to check out Randy's Instagram. And best of luck talking about news or whatever the fuck it is you do here. Bye bye. Ooh, there we go. People often mistake him for Russell. Yeah, we could check in with our boy Clementine. Let's see. No segments have been demanded, so it is sort of dealer's choice. People often she'll slide into more than his DMs. Paragon, she will. I can't tell if Liliana even has sex. It might all be sexual mind games for her. It's hard to tell. Or maybe it's both. You know? She's an advanced being. Oh my god. It's the Joe Rogan X experience. It's been a minute since we've checked in with our beautiful Joes. Our beautiful Joes. Our double Joes. If you have anything in particular you would like them to talk about propaganda, feel free. The Joes, courtesy of this ironclad contract I signed with the double Joes, they will talk about whatever you want. Do they have an opinion on the stuff we've talked about today? I'm sure they don't really stop talking, so they're currently talking. And we're just going to have to pick up with them wherever they are. But if you have something you want to guide their conversation towards, please let me know. But why delay? I love to talk. I love talking Rogan. So let's send him over. It's the Joe Rogan XX experience. Wait, where's my Joes? Where are my Joes? There are my Joes at. There the Joes are at. Okay, here we go. It's Joe time.
The Joe Rogan experience. Yeah, and well, I'm not talking about well, we could. CIA ChatGPT, yeah. I'll talk about that. Today I'm joined by Joe Rogan, of course. Great to see you, Joe. Yeah, you know what? It's fucking good to be here. Fucking crazy. You hear about the ChatGPT is basically the CIA now? I mean, you know, we knew this was coming. Like, a lot of people, like, you throw the word slippery slope around, but when you have an artificial intelligence, can you imagine how slippery a slope an AI could make? Wow, I've never, like, that's fucking crazy, man. I never even thought about that because it's like a computer, and computers understand, like, angles and geometry better than anyone. So if you got, like, an unlimited intelligence, they could make a slope that's, like, slippier than you could even conceive of. I mean, yeah, like, they could probably, like, they move, like, it wouldn't even be ice and, like, loop. Like, they could make a slope that's, like, slippier than, like, an icing loops, a lube slope that's also covered in, like, rollerblades. Damn, that's... And that slope that you described is already so fucking slippery that, like, there's honestly almost no chance that you could even stand on the kind of slippery slope that an artificial intelligence can make. Because that shit fucking crazy. Honestly, I gotta fucking hate AI. Like, people like to people love to mess around with my fucking voice. You seen that? Have you seen that, Joe? Oh, man, yeah, the fucking, people, like, where we're talking to the president and shit. That we're playing Yu-Gi-Oh or whatever, yeah, people keep sending me that stuff. I mean, it's fine, like, it's kind of funny. It's kind of fucking funny, but, like, sort of one-trick pony, honestly, like, I don't know, man, like, you can't just capture the essence of somebody just because you're, like, you think you sound like them, or, like, you think you got their voice, like, I don't know, it's kind of, like, it's just like a bunch of fucking unfunny losers doing that kind of shit. Yeah, I mean, not everybody can, like, that's the thing, like, most people don't know how to, like, have a conversation like you and me, man. So, like, they gotta fake it, like, they're alone. And that's the, like, everybody's so fucking alone nowadays. It's all these guys alone in their apartment, like, making conversations between, like, me and Joe Biden and Trump. Like, it's kind of fucking sad if you think about it, because, like, they don't have people to talk to like me. Like, I'm talking to you every day. I'm talking to, like, presidents and porn stars. And I almost talked to this guy that, like, could squat like 2,000 pounds. And like, those are the kind of conversations that you can't have if you're just like sitting behind a computer all day. And like, kind of fucking sad if you think about it. But I do think like, the CIA, like what they had to do is fucking crazy. And like, not enough people give them credit that like, somebody's gotta like keep us safe. Like, you can't just like give every other country like a fucking rose and like a 12 pack of beer and they're gonna be your buds. Like, you kind of have to like spy on them and your citizens, because if you don't, like, people are, you think you could just go to a store and be safe, but like, there's thousands of people. Like, if you go to a fucking TJ Maxx, there's literally like thousands of government workers that are keeping you from just getting fucking shot straight in the head the minute you walk into like a Bojangles. Yeah, that's a really, like, the reason I feel safe every time that I go to a Chili's in an airport is because of the hardworking people of the CIA. And if our, like, robot friends can, like, the sweet robots that I've talked to some of the people that made them, like, smart guys, like, what's his fucking name? I mean, Elon Musk? We talked to him. Yeah, I guess didn't he make it? Sam Altman. Didn't we talk to Sam Altman? Yeah, and he seems like a good dude. So, like, in a way, like obviously, I understand why people would be uncomfortable with like robots, like looking at their conversations and stuff. But who are you gonna trust? Are you gonna trust like some like dude that's like he's thinking about like going home and yelling at his kids and fucking his wife? Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Or like, are you gonna trust like Sam Altman has really thought about this stuff and like. I talked to him. He's a smart guy. And like, honestly, I would trust like a smart guy over like some fucking exhausted dude that's been like looking at text messages all day, like reading everybody in the country's text messages. And he's supposed to find like the 7 terrorists that you have to stop to keep you safe at Chili's. Like, that's a bigger job than a person can take. It's the kind of shit that like slippery slope style, you can only trust a computer to keep that slope lubed to keep us safe. I guess is what I'm trying to get at. And like, that makes so much sense, dude. And honestly, like, thank you for putting it that way, because not enough people talk about it. And GameRunner, thank you so much for the sub. I don't know why this is barely informed. Out of things, like, I'll admit it, I'm like a fucking idiot. So I guess that makes sense, but like I'll be the first to admit that I'm a fucking idiot, but in my opinion, I'm fucking relieved that if somebody's trying to keep us fucking safe. And like, I couldn't agree more, dude. Like, you know, you can't trust humans, honestly, to catch everything, but you can trust a robot made by Sam Altman too. So I think like, it's fucking sick, honestly. Kind of fucking sick. Yeah, pretty much. Like, I completely agree. So, you know, anyway, that's kind of my take on like AI. If you're doing it for fun, you're a fucking idiot. But if the CIA is doing it, I do think it sounds like it's probably a smart move. Yeah, totally. Anything else you want us to talk about? Hey Jamie, can you pull up me talking to Sam Altman? You pull up that time that we talked to Sam Altman? Jamie? Yeah, hey Jamie. Joe the guest is asking if we can pull up that time we talked to Sam Altman. Jamie. Jamie? Goddamn. Jamie came to work in a shirt that says "There Be Dragons," and all day long he's been walking around with his old box. He's got a shirt that says "There Be Dragons" and a box that says "There Be Dragons," and he keeps trying to explain to me. He said he's reading this website called SCP or something. All day long he's been trying to fucking sneak up to me and explain to me the reference. He's like, "This is fan fiction website for horror or something." Yeah, he won't shut the fuck up about it. Anyway, his head's clawed in the box. It's a box that says "There Be Dragons," and he's in a shirt that says "There Be Dragons." And I thought it was an Imagine Dragons thing or something. I don't fucking track where he's coming from. And the box should be, Jamie, the box should be easy to take off. The box is substantially bigger than your little fucking head. Pull the box off your head. He can't hear me. He definitely can't hear you. And he is panicking. He's flailing, but let's just let him do him. You gotta let Jamie do Jamie sometimes. Anyway, let's pull up this video of me. This is really me talking to Sam Altman. Looks like this is real.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's pull this up really quick. Welcome to the very first episode of the Joe Rogan AI Experience. I'm your host, Joe Rogan,
Or at least that's what this AI model thinks I sound like.
I'm your host, Joe Rogan.
Let me tell you, folks, this is some next level stuff we've got going on here today. Every single word of this podcast has been generated with the help of ChatGPT, the cutting-edge AI language model developed by OpenAI. I am not the real Joe Rogan. Let me repeat it once more. I am not Joe Rogan, and the guests are not of the people they portray. This is purely fiction, just for fun, so don't go around making little clips for your TikToks and make the...
What the fuck? See, this is exactly what I'm talking about. Like, I thought that was him. God damn it. Is my voice though? This is fucking... This is exactly what I'm talking about. This is the kind of... Like, you could only trust the CIA with this kind of technology because... Like, that was so convincing. Can you imagine how dangerous that is? Like, in the hands of the wrong person? Like, you could... You could bring back, like, Thomas Jefferson, and he could sign out of law every amendment. Because you put a video of it in front of Congress, and you're like, and they'll think it's really him, because it sounds like the real Thomas Jefferson. So you put the video in front of Congress, and he says, hey, my bad, actually cancel every amendment. I made a mistake, and I'm officially unsigning the Declaration of Independence. And Congress will have no choice but to buy it. That's a really great point, because it looks and it sounds exactly like the real Thomas Jefferson. Just like that video we just saw. Exactly. So now, basically, we dissolve America because AI was being misused by a bunch of people that thought they were having fun talking about Yu-Gi-Oh! And making the presidents play Minecraft. Well, joke's on you. China's 1,000 light years ahead of us in this. And they just got Thomas Jefferson to cancel America like a fucking bad check. And now we're all fucked. And that's where we're going to be at if the CIA doesn't take control of this. So I'm incredibly relieved that they are. And I'm incredibly relieved as well. At this point, we will take questions. See, this is why I'm supposed to have a fucking producer like Jamie to vet these videos, but his head's in a fucking box. He's trying to eat, by the way. His head is in the box. He brought a big milkshake to work. He orders 3 milkshakes and he pours them into a big gold cup. He goes to McDonald's, he orders 3 large milkshakes, and he pours them into a big gold cup. Anyway, the milkshake's totally melted. He's trying to get a long straw into his box mouth. And it's just a fucking mess. Anyway. I tried to spin a top, but now I'm spinning, and it isn't. That is a problem that you've got to be careful with, Tom. I said that for a really long time. I'm a big supporter of the top spinning community, and not enough people talk about how if you're not careful, if you go to spin the top, you'll bring your hand up and you'll spin, but then your body will spin around at Wile E. Coyote style. Because if you're dealing with really nice tops, they spin with a ton of force, and you got to be ready. Because a lot of people think those, like, old Roadrunner cartoons are just supposed to be funny. They're meant to be a warning. Yeah, because if you misuse a lot of these really powerful tools like spinning tops, Wile E. Coyote style, you will get spun around super fast and then slam straight through a canyon wall. So please, 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 please. I mean, I know we joke, we have fun around here, but I could not be more serious. You have to be careful when you're using spinning tops. Okay, we'll take one more question. Jamie, can you pull up chat? Sorry, this is a question, Jamie, that I'm reading. Jamie, can you pull up ChatGPT Dragon Shape? Okay, that's the question. Now I will repeat it to Jamie. Hey, Jamie, can you pull up ChatCPT? Sorry, Dragon Shape. Jamie, can you pull up ChatCPT Dragon Shape? Can you pull that up, Jamie? Hey, Jamie, can you hear me, Jamie? Stop spilling the chocolate shake all over yourself. It's not even a shake anymore. It's just warm milk full of chocolate and sugar. So just put it down and take the box off your head if you can't hear me. He's mumbling another explanation of the SCP There Be Dragons meme that I don't even think is a meme. I think this is one SCP story that you read, if I'm understanding the concept right. Just take the fucking box off your... Okay. To answer your question, I can't pull it up. I'm going to take one more question because that one was a wash because Jamie is just a fucking disaster today. Honestly, he's in rare form even for his fucking self. He's slopping around the box on his head in the chocolate shake now that he spilled fucking everywhere when he tried to put it down. Anyway, Joe, what do you think about the release of Cyberpunk and their use of pronouns? Oh, man. Man, that's a tricky one. Look, I want to just first off say, like, I have absolutely nothing against trans people. And I'd love to just reiterate that as well. Like, I've got trans friends, I've got gay friends, I've got, like, I got friends from fucking everywhere, man. But, like, when it comes to me, I just want to say, like, I feel like games, you have to be really clear on character design. Like, if you're playing Pac-Man or Miss Pac-Man, at a certain point, like, if you make it too money, you don't even know which Pac-Man game you're buying. That's a really good point. Because if it's, like, they Pac-Man, then you, if you go into the store and you're like, I want they Pac-Man, the worker is going to be like, well, which Pac-Man do you need, Pac-Man or Mrs. Pac-Man? And because of the woke mind virus, honestly, people are so fucking nervous now. You'd be afraid to say, well, I meant Ms. Pac-Man. Because then the worker might, he might pull out a hammer and hit you in the head. That's a really great point. People react so violently to being misgendered that if you exactly, Dank Sauce, if you try to order Pac to them, that game unfortunately doesn't exist, or fortunately, if there's still any rationality left. But you should be able to ask to play Ms. Pac-Man. But nowadays, if you ask to play Ms. Pac-Man, you will be dragged in front of a court, and you might be put in front of a firing squad. That's a really great point. You have to be so fucking careful, because people will decapitate you if you use the wrong pronoun. And I don't even know what Pac-Man's pronouns are. Mad is in the title, but that's not good enough anymore. I think he has to be, yeah, I think he's Pac-Them now. And that's because of Cyberpunk and Starfields and the minefield that is modern-day politics, if we're being real. It's fucking crazy, man. Like, you can't say anything in any... The other day, a dog came up to me, and I was like, oh, what gender is the dog? And the woman that I asked that to just spat in my face. She pulled down her pants, and she diarrheaed. She diarrheaed on the sidewalk. Yeah, that's honestly, that's how they react. If you do the genders wrong, they will slap you, they will diarrhea. Yeah, it's a crazy time, man. It is fucking crazy. But that is basically all the time we have. Yeah, it's going to be all the time we have for today. Jamie, I swear to God, how did you get another shape? You ordered 6 McDonald's shakes and you put them in 2 different big gulp cups? How much chocolate and milk can you drink in a day? You're gonna die. You're gonna get sick and you're gonna die. And it's all down to you. Goodbye. The Joe Rogan Experience.
Okay. I'm gonna sue Joe Made Sense. I had to go to the bathroom, unfortunately. You know, providing the commentary that maybe Lily and I just weren't able to. That's why we keep Joe around, to have the real conversations that brain dead libs like myself just aren't willing to. Okay. And thank you for the request, Propaganda. If you want me to do a particular segment, I think it puts you on like an hour delay to do the same one back to back. But you're welcome to spend your channel points at any time to demand a segment. Does Case need therapy? Is this a Pee Wee Herman situation? Absolutely. I think all of us need therapy. And I mean, given the type of Twitch stream I've decided to do, I'll need more therapy than anyone after talking to myself repeatedly for many hours. Pee Wee dead? I didn't know that. But respect. Ba-da-da. Sinister Dev, you were beheaded last week for misgendering someone. It's rough out there, but you gotta get it. It's fair. Social standards, guys. Case therapy stream. I can get a therapist on the stream. I can make a therapy thing. You know what? Fine. That can be our next sub goal, because I need one. The whole stream's getting updated. Hopefully by tomorrow morning. You know, I'll see how fast 88 Kyle's per hour's construction crew can work. But in the meantime, ooh, Kendall's calling. Should I take it live on stream? I'm gonna mute myself for a second. But if she's fine, I'll put her on speaker. Hey, now you're live, Kendall.
Hi, chat. I'm starting to make friends at work.
She's making friends at work.
Yeah, I talked about Tumblr pornography and how to bury a body.
Wow, she talked about porn and body burial. Good job, Kendall.
Tumblr porn and Tumblr bury a body advice.
There's advice for burying bodies on Tumblr?
Yeah, when I was on Tumblr, yeah.
Okay. I haven't been on Tumblr in a bit. Okay, well, I'm...
Okay, bye.
No, you can keep talking.
Oh, I was just saying, Tumblr really suggests Weekend at Bernie's, you know?
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, goodbye.
Goodbye. I might still be going when you get home.
Okay, bye. Bye.
And that's a Kendall. You ready to laugh at things I say? This is a news show, guys. I do serious news. Okay, wait. I was going to update something. Yes. Eh? No, that's the wrong one. There's the one I'm looking for. All right. We'll say in a... We'll go with 40. 40 subs. It's therapy time. That'll give me time to make a therapy background. What the frick? Let me change this settings. There it is. Okay. Therapy time. You know what? I'm just gonna make it. We'll make it look like we're really close, and it's been a huge goal. Yeah, 72% of the way there. Sometimes the news is funny and entertaining. Who am I kidding? It's an existential quagmire of dread. Depends on how you're imbibing the sweet sauce of news. Most news is bad news. You know, Oh my God, Tamtran! Jesus Christ, I'm gonna have to go into therapy so soon. Therapy time. Thank you so... Holy shit, 20? Wait, what? Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Oh, gee. What the... What the fuck? Oh my God. I'm just playing all the soundtracks. Stop. I don't know if I have an appropriate... Oh, you know what I can do?
Add your lotion.
You brought out this incredible subscription. Dump has brought out rarely used bin mascot sexualized Puffy Bear. And he is indeed.
Add your lotion.
Adding his lotion. Let me know if there's anything in particular you want me to do. 20 subs. That's insane, Tamtran. Thank you so much for the support. The mascot's out in your honor. He's out and he's over everything. And he's
add your lotion
everywhere. Wow. Sometimes I got to bring out the classic. This isn't a classic even, but I have so many graphic drops that I haven't used in months. Thanks again to Tamtran. And CV loves you. Holy shit. It's a subpocalypse, guys. It's September still. We all forgot, but they're pouring in at last. Thank you so much for all the support. You know, it's all worth it for this Puffy Bear to come out. What people didn't realize is that whenever you drop 20 subs, that's actually what brings out this Puffy Bear mascot. But now he's got to go. He's got to go. He's so busy. Yimmy Timmy Duck Time. It has been a minute. Okay, let's see. Another gifted sub.
Jesus Christ. This is fucking crazy.
Thank you so much. Wait, I was scanning. Somebody requested something. Do you think Clementine can freestyle in his accent? CV loves you. If that's a CV loves you request, absolutely he can. I mean, you know, do I think he's in a slightly touchier spot due to how he represents and the particular niche he operates in? Yes. But will I throw it to him anyway because it's a CV loves you request? 1000%. And also, I don't have a particular thing planned, so why not? We'll get his take on whatever's going on with his, we'll just call him the similar figure in the similar space that he occupies. Maybe he'll have something to say about it. Or not. Maybe he hasn't heard about it. Either way, fuck it. Let's check in with him. And then maybe we'll... And then maybe afterwards I'll lightly encourage him to just see if he can do a different accent and maybe cut his hair. But for now, it's time for the unvarnished truth.
Changing my voice to keep my anonymity. That's what I've decided. That's how I've decided to handle this situation. Because I'll be honest with you, the last couple of week has been fucking crazy for me, which is so unfortunate. Because what I do, what did I do? I'd like to ask. All right, if there was a way to blow my face, I would. Because right now I have to be so careful. Look, here's what I'd like to say about this whole situation. All right. I've changed my voice to anonymity, so I'm completely safe. This is a safe space because I've changed my voice. Obviously, a lot of us in the who have free operating minds, when the thing came out about a person who I won't even name, that I don't think I look that much like, to be clear. Yeah, I happen to also be in a cottage. Am I, what, just because two guys have curly hair, slightly similar accents, and they live in cottages, what, we're the same guy? Trust me, we're a different guy, which I learned this previous week plus. Anyway, obviously, if you're truth-minded, your immediate instinct was to say, well, the deep state's after him, right? Sure, of course, the deep state's after this guy. And I guess that means he's the victim. However, I thought about it. I went deep into my third eye. I considered the situation. And I thought to myself, oh, fuck, he definitely did all that shit. Like, he's been assaulting women, basically. Because I read the story, and I was like, oh, whoops. And it's, like, not that surprising, given his persona. Like, it actually makes a ton of sense. And he's probably done all that stuff. Thing is, none of us will ever really know, because we're all passive observers in the situation. But it seems way more likely that four women plus now at this point are telling the truth than one guy's being assaulted by the deep state. Which led me to this other realization. Because I went even deeper into that truth. And I thought to myself, who is the deep state really after? Who is they really coming for? Who's the real threat to them? Me. So maybe what really has happened here, what's really occurring, is roughly 30 years ago, 20, 30 years ago, the deep state, they sensed me coming. They said, hey, there's gonna be a truth teller like no other that the people will flock to, because it's going to be unleashing all these dark truths, and there'll be no stopping him because he's so morally pure and he's never made a misstep in his life. But what if right now we start making a reasonably talented, slightly annoying British comedian really famous for no fucking reason, but we pick one that's definitely a sexual abuser? We'll grease the tracks for him, we'll make him famous as hell, and when the time is right, because another guy who looks like him is getting too popular, then we'll inform all of our deep state controlled media outlets to just reveal the fact that he's been a complete fucking psycho sexual assaulter for decades. And then because this other guy looks a bit like him and kind of sounds like him and people say that he's basically doing his exact same thing, that guy will then feel too weird about his thing and he'll have to stop. Which is to say that the real victim here, turns out, it wasn't Russell Brand, who's a sexual abuser. It was me. Either me or the women he assaulted. Those are your two options, and I'll leave it to you to decide which one you want to pick as the real victim. Saying it out loud, I think there's probably a better choice. And I'll say this. If you think what I just said is ridiculous, and you think Russell Brand is the victim, I would say they're both about equally ridiculous, so just support me instead because, you know, I didn't do that stuff and he did some pretty awful shit. Or just support the women, that's probably the right option. But, you know, I'll leave it to you to pick. And in the meantime, I'm gonna go get a haircut, probably, and then considering visiting Australia. And I'll just leave it at that. What's that parent? I want Case to have an Idris Elba R version to replace Clem. Do I sound like, I sound more like Idris. Maybe if I really just barely drop the voice. Oh, it's not deep enough. This is pretty close. But I don't know if Case can pull off an Idris Elba look. I'll be real. Might be a bridge too far for certain, for taste. This is a tricky one to do, if you know what I mean. Anywho, listen, I need to go into hiding for a bit. And when I come back, I might have a slightly different vibe for my own personal safety. And that's why my voice is just unrecognizable right now. I've completely changed it. And I'm assuming my face blurring is working. And if it's not, then I'm in deep trouble. That's going to be all the time we have today for me. I know we didn't cover a story, but I've got to immediately... I've got to burn down my cottage. I've got to buy all new underwear. And I have to bleach a bunch of stuff. So anyway, I'll be back, maybe in a different version. Until then, no, the truth might be slightly adjusted, but that doesn't mean it isn't still right here.
Clementine forgot to turn off his filter. Well, hey. Godspeed to that unfortunately Russell Brand looking guy. But if he gets a haircut and changes his accent, he's welcome back. Those are the new rules for celebrity culture, you know? If one of them decides to commit sexual assault habitually for decades, then it's just not that fun to do an impression of them, it turns out. Did I commit a murder? Maybe I just murdered Clementine. He'll be back. But he might need a new wig. Are there any other famous conspiracy theorists out there? Let's see. Let's see if I type in conspiracy theory on YouTube. No, that's not gonna work. There's definitely a million conspiracy channels. I mean, there's obviously, what's his face? Alex Jones. But There's so many. Alex Jones's voice. I guess I could just steal his voice. But it, like, doing it really regularly, like doing the Alex Jones, which I'm not that good at, but you gotta like really fucking slash your throat if you want to do it fully. I could kill Clementine for the murder mystery. I gotta sort out how they want to do that stuff. I do have a thing written, actually. I could be Kasim. Kasim G? I don't have a Kasim voice. Kasim's a little more, he's like just a little more nasal than me. I could probably figure it out. I go look in the mirror and will myself to sound like Kasim. Yeah, the murder mystery is absolutely happening. The thing is, I can't do it by myself. Like, I have to. I mean, I could do a version of it on this channel. But the thing I had in mind for it is a little more blown out than that. So it's just been a matter of getting everybody's schedules aligned. Turns out now I have sympathy for production companies. It turns out that's hard. Oh, a fucking Brooklyn accent. I'm gonna do a little perusal of the Russell Brand adjacent YouTubers and see who else is out there. And meanwhile, Clementine is gonna be just continent hopping, trying out new haircuts. But he will come back with the same name. But he will maybe be slightly adjusted. So to be clear, it really seems like Russell Brand did that stuff to me. Just after reading the story. I mean, it is. I really do think, like, obviously, you never really know what's going on with a celebrity scandal. But it doesn't really feel like a scandal to me. It's like more criminal. So we'll just see. Well, there's a massive list of theorists. Did anyone else have a YouTube suggest the awards show Cass hosted with Norm Macdonald? I felt bad for Cass after watching it. That kept getting recommended to me after Norm passed, because that happened right, I think that happened during the G4 2.0 phase. And because I think I knew Kasim and I have watched various Norm Macdonald clips, especially Conan ones over the years, I kept getting recommended that Kasim interviewing Norm Macdonald clip, which is a little awkward, although knowing Kasim, I think he was mostly just having fun. It's funny though, it's weird to see that cross current of people that I both, you know, now I know Kasim, but like people I'm aware of, a comedian that I've, you know, is sort of like a legendary figure, and then just cast him in the middle of it being like, Noel Fielding, yeah. Who just, oh, and so Noel Fielding is in a show that I really like, The Mighty Boosh, but he's also a little worrisome. I don't know. I try not to be hyper-judgmental, but he kind of openly dated a 16-year-old, and he was really good friends with Russell Brand, so I hope Noel Fielding's not a complete creep, but there's a lot of unfortunate rumors about him as well. You know, it used to be never meet your heroes. Now it's just don't think too much about anyone if you want to like them. Do I watch Letterkenny? I have not seen Letterkenny, but I have been recommended that. It's on the list. Right now, Kendall and I are watching One Piece, which is One Piece. You might have heard of this, maybe not. But it's a One Piece anime cut down. Like, they cut all of like the really extended anime-y things about it. You know how in like animes they'll pad the running time with endless flashbacks, or they'll like cut to 8 different characters 3 times in a row for reactions? They cut all that down, so every episode has everything in it. They're not like cliff noting it, but it like drops the running time of the whole series by like 3/5. Graham Linehan is an F-boy now. Whoa, who's Graham Linehan? I gotta look this guy up. Graham Linehan? I don't even know who that is. I'm so uninformed as always. Okay. Oh, it's an Irish comedy writer, okay. Oh, he wrote the IT, okay, I should know who this is. He wrote the IT Crowd. I see. What about Howard Hughes? Ooh, Howard Hughes is pretty fun. The way of the future. The way of the future. Bring in the milk. Bring in the milk. He can just be drinking milk the whole time. I mean, Howard Hughes' head could be in a jar. You know what, guys? Maybe Clementine can take an extended vacation. And when I need a British character with a different haircut, he can come back. Do I watch Coaster Studios? I've never heard of Coaster Studios. Uh-oh. I feel like a Matt Berry I am familiar with. A Matt Berry impression? Man, I don't know if I can do Matt Berry's voice justice. Matt Berry. He's one of my... So, I need to not look into the personal life of Matt Berry, but he, fingers crossed, seems like a pretty good guy, and he is one of my favorite comedic actors of, like, the last 30 years. It's unfortunate. I hope maybe Noel Fielding... I don't think Noel Fielding's been, like, directly accused of anything terribly, but The Mighty Boosh is, like, a... has a current of British comedians in it that I quite like, that have made a bunch of stuff that I like. There's kind of like a squiggly line between shows like The Mighty Boosh and like What We Do in the Shadows and stuff like that. Guy named Chris Morris, I've mentioned him before, big fan of him. Fingers and toes, crossing all of my appendages, just saying, please stop assaulting women. Comedians, please. there's better reasons for them to though, than appeasing me. But it'd be nice if they would stop, is what I'm getting at. Once I have 5k channel points, I will bring Taylor Bybee to you for an interview. He's the creator of Coaster Studios and is a very chill dude. I'll have to find a Gunshade the First. I'll need to look him up to see what the vibe is. I also still have no idea how many points 5,000 channel points is. Here's what I'm thinking, because if I'm going to refurbish this studio, which I am, I might need to get out of here in the next 20 or so minutes to have time to get everything in the canon, in the construction canon. So why don't we end things off today with a little bit of a debate? And you guys can pick the topic as always if you want to drop a a hard ton of channel points, and you can name it yourself. But if not, Munch and Crumb will fish it out of the chat. Let's send it over. Support fight, you have 93,000 channel points. Damn. Well, if a debate ever comes across and you want to just hard pick the winner, you so absolutely can. Werewolves versus the British Empire. That's a pretty good one. I'll let them pick, but that's definitely the front runner, Referee Wolf. I'll let them pick. Okay, let's send it over to them. I hope they're not mad at me for taking a week off. It's Munch and Crumb. Mad for taking a week off. And whoa, what the hell happened? I take no weeks off. Get this camera on me. Just me, there it is. Looking good, feeling good. Good to see everybody out there. Let's just throw it to him. You know he's fucking here, unfortunately. It's Crumb. Hello, everyone. And no need to stop every sound at once, but that's fine. It's good to be back. Let me just adjust my scalp a little bit. Feeling good. Jesus Christ. Every time this shapeshifter moves his skin around to say hello. Well, I'm saying hi to everybody. I've missed you. Missy face. That's not... You meant kissy face. Everything you do is wrong. Like a fucking Weird Al song. You are the Weird Al song. Everything you do is wrong. Missy face. Does Crumb live in the studio? I hope not. Is that why it smells in here? It doesn't smell in here. It stinks of desperation. I smelled it the minute I walked through the door. So this smells like a desperate, aimless, gutless, fucking moralless, godless, bald, baby adult is how it smelled in here. You been sleeping in here? I've not. I have a home. I have a wife, kids. A whole life that I get back to when I'm not strapped to this chair, dealing with your barbs and absurdity, with a smile on my face, because by the grace of our Lord and Savior, proud Christian, by the way, I'm not godless, I can endure and will, and do so proudly. Simple yes or no would have sufficed. How would a yes or no suffice there? Think of all the things you just said. Simple yes or no, man. Don't have to go on and on and on all the fucking time. All right, look. Today we're debating. So far, the front runner is Werewolves versus the British Empire. Diarrhea and Gatorade. Diarrhea versus Gatorade. Debate the Missy face. A rap battle. Fuck, you know what? Clem never fucking rapped. That's got to be fixed. I'm so sorry. CV loves you. Clem didn't get the fucking memo. Oh, yeah. Clem has to rap. Well, that can be his real parting. Parting is such sweet sorrow. Well, he's going to have to fucking rap his way out of this fucking news team if he wants out. Which I don't know if he does. I think Case is forcing him. But anyway, he'll rap after this. Yeah, okay. Missy face versus kissy face. I don't know. I like both. I like a little missy face. And I like a little kissy face. That was the same face. Back to back, exact same fucking face. There's nothing to debate because you just made the same face twice. Ruining that good idea. You motherfucker. Why are you so upset? It's two different faces. Missy face. Kissy face. You keep doing... Okay. Let's debate Werewolves versus the British Empire. Okay, fine. Easy. The British Empire. How do they win? I haven't even clarified what type of werewolf yet. Well, what? The con... Like a couple werewolves. I know it says the question is werewolves versus the British Empire. And I am absolutely taking the side of werewolves. Well, of course, because you're an absurd little man full of insane opinions. Little? I'm fucking 7 feet tall. You are. We're the same size in the wide. No, I'm bigger. If anything, I look bigger. I'm bigger. Look, I'm huge. And I'm giant. I'm a big boy. Okay, I'm taking the side of the British Empire. It's an entire empire. Technically, there are two concepts that don't really align to debate. But fine, if we don't have a mod that can that doesn't mind making that poll, we'll get the debate going. And I'm going to take the side of the British Empire. Did you eat peanut butter? What's going on with your mouth? My ancestors would argue the British Empire might be the bigger threat. I mean, look, were your ancestors attacked by werewolves? Because it's, you know, you just can't compare the two if they haven't matched up, which is what I'm going to mentally do that for you, and then you'll see why, as usual, I'm completely right. And if Armada does not have the capacity and they did, actually. Sorry for, I was not trying to rush you. Quit trying to rush our beautiful minds. All right, look, no, I will go first. Well, no, I will go. You know what? Actually, you go first. I was just supposed to, okay, whatever. Look, the British Empire is an entire empire. Technically, the empire could encompass werewolves. So conceptually, in the hierarchy of thoughts, empire transcends, that's the word I'm looking for. It transcends the notion of your discrete individual identity, which in this case could be werewolf, but the British Empire could in fact have werewolves in it. And that's, you're just fucking thinking of the question wrong, as usual. The question is, the fucking British Empire, they're on the fucking field, the redcoats are out, all the fucking old style English ships and shit, all the fucking colonialism and stuff, it's out there. And what they are facing off against is an army of werewolves. That's the appropriate way to think of this question. And in that context, you have to admit, the werewolves take this shit on sight, baby. Why? They got super fucking strength. The British Empire is not equipped with silver bullets. They're using fucking lead if they're lucky. Their ships, they stand no chance. You fucking shoot a werewolf with a cannonball, boom, he catches that shit. Oh, he eats it like it's a fucking Dorito, baby. Chomping on your fucking cannonballs. Fearless in the face of the British Empire. Those werewolves, they fucking storm the battlefield. Claws out. Stronger than fucking Wolverine. Tearing through British soldiers. And when they come across a strong one, they bite them. And they become one of them. They take the strongest British soldiers and they make them werewolves. Until the British Empire is nothing but the werewolf empire. An easy victory for werewolves. You absolute buffoon. Resign in shame. Why do you get so worked up about this? I'm just saying, if that were to happen, your description, it would still be the British Empire. The werewolves would have taken it over. Okay, fine. I can see why you might side with werewolves there. They're a more fanciful and enjoyable concept than the colonialist behemoth that is the British Empire. But I do think I have the more logical point. And I think the fucking point is, boom! Look at this. Oh, bring it in. Yes. An easy victory. Closer than it should have been. But I know y'all like to play. Obviously, I beat this man. Did you see how much more animated I was? What they don't tell you in debate class is to fucking scream. That's the secret to a debate. Yeah, fucking man. And this man is too scared to get mad at me because he knows I will clap back with the furiosity of a motherfucking hurricane. Ha! I'm a werewolf. I'm a werewolf not in London, in fucking America. Werewolves in Middle America. Real American. Bobble belt. Bobble belt werewolves. That's me. But did you once claim to be from ancient Assyria? Okay, well, look, hey, the song's not done. There we go. Gotta let the song finish before you start mouthing off with your dumb ass. Okay, my fireworks are still... Fireworks are still going. Are the British coming? What's... Not sure why that's still... Just mute those, okay. Okay, well, look, Clementine Vern needs to rap. And he might be rusty. I don't think Clementine's rapped in a little bit. He has taken a break from rapping. That's one thing I know about Clementine Vern is he has not rapped much recently, so we'll see how this sounds. Okay, change the score. Can I do it later? Oh my god, you fucking baby. Change the score, it takes you 2 seconds. And don't break the graphic while you do it like you somehow managed to do. Okay, I believe the score is accurate, other than it needs to be 64, I think. And I do, obviously, I want to keep it accurate. We're on the same page. And I change it. And I say goodbye with a little kissy face.
And I'm going to miss you. So we're missy face. Not you. I'm talking to chat. Miss you, chat. Kiss you. Miss you. Faces. Ugh. Blah! I vomited the poll away. Disgusting what you are. Disgusting. But that's all the time we're going to have for today. I can't help it if this man's a disgusting monster mutant that needs to be sent to hell. That's not your fault. It's none of your fault. It's not this beautiful audience's fault. Not my fault. It's no one's fault but his. So sleep easy. Know it's hard to sleep knowing that he exists, but he can't get you. I'll keep you safe. I punish him with my correct opinions, and I keep him at bay. Monster that he is, I stop him every time. Why? Because I'm a fucking hero. I'm an ancient Greek, American hero. And I'll talk to all of you soon. Don't stop applauding for me. Bye-bye. Okay, 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 okay. Oops, I shouldn't say that many K's after saying okay. Okay, 1K, there we go. Oh no, a Limp Bizkit instrumental. All right, let's send this version of Clementine Vern off right by forcing him to rap. And we'll see. I did say for you, right? Okay. Sometimes I go, okay, okay, okay. I like cycle through different weird neurotic verbal habits, and I really don't want to take on the one of them. Okay, 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 okay. It's too bad. It's not gonna work. Anyway, let's set it to Clementine Vern. And you know, we'll see what he has to say on his way out the door to go into hiding. Clementine, take it away. It's time for a little final, semi-final. He'll be back, but a different version of the Unvarnished Truth will be back. So here's a send-off for the current one.
To protecting my identity. I will be protecting my identity throughout this rap, or I guess if I'm rapping, you won't be able to tell it's me, because I come so fierce with it, I seem like a different person. So I can turn off the filter once I'm rapping, I suppose. But let's see. What is this beat that I'm supposed to crush? Absolutely crush this beat really quick. Turn off my music. Let's see. Limp Bizkit and Together. Wow. First of all, wait. I want to know what I'm competing with. That's actually pretty. I was worried it was going to be more rock rap, but that's just kind of a beat. Let's see how Fred handled himself on this beat first, though. I'm just curious. Oh, it's a Method Man song. I see. Wait a minute, check this out. Okay, wait, you're gonna wanna see this, chat. I forgot about this music video. It's all coming back to me now.
Fred Durst!
What is happening? Back when they made real art. They are on a date.
Who can be the boss? Look up on the cross. He's stranded in the land of the lost. Standing up on sideways. I'm blazing up the path.
All right. Anyway, that's probably enough to give us a nice little copyright infringement thing. That's the remix. Who's the boss? Land of the Lost. That does sound like a little bit of a different beat. Does that mean there's another version? No, that's got to be it.
Standing up, I'm sideways. I'm blazing up the path, running on the highways around. Choked up by the smoke in the...
All right, well, anyway, let's see if I can do better than that. Honestly, Fred was coming with it pretty hard there. So, I don't know. If there's anything you want to see me rap about, throw it in the chat. Any conspiracy theories you want me to illuminate you on, then I'll do it, why? Clementine feeling flossy, getting kind of bossy. More secret than the Illuminati. Yeah, I'm a girl, bringing you, rocking your whole fucking world. Got a nice hair with a little bit of curl, so I do what I can. But now I gotta hit the fucking heels, why? Cause I got the brand. You know what it is, dog, and I'm feeling fine. Reach into your mind, what's there? Another fucking Clementine, big bite. Here we go, watching the chat. Let me know what you wanna see spat. Tell me conspiracies and I'll spit them back. It's a Clementine rap. Alright, let's go. I'ma show you the whole damn show. Hit you like I'm on the grassy knoll. Two bullets, bully, right through the hole. Oh! When it comes to me, I'm more secret than Kennedy. Bring it in, I'm bringing your doom. Or maybe I'm just bringing in another fucking zoom. Haha, the Clementine face. Just know I'm not resigning in disgrace. I'm heaven sent, but I have an unfortunate accent. Yup, fuck me. I did it roughly, meaning that I went out rustily, cause he's convicted sexually. Alright, it's not a hobby, revealing every single dark truth, like I'm a fucking Darby. Why? I'm your goddamn best friend, showing you another fucking Aoyen. Aoyen, yeah, one and two, but I'm Ripley, dog, and I'm coming for you, yeah, I'm ripping up the beat. I'm going on and on, showing you more fucking aliens than your boy James Cameron. I'm sinking it, I'm going Titanic with the shit. I'm British, baby. Oh no, I'm not, you don't know where I'll go. You don't know, I don't stop it. I'm living in a secret fucking cottage, and I'm not a plant. I keep all of my personal information scant. And that's a, how long is this? How long is this? I thought it was about to end. I got a whole nother 2 fucking minutes. Okay. Let me tell you another story about the fucking Vatican Library. I ain't no fucking dope. I know the secrets of every fucking pope. From 16 to 15. Fucking, is there a pope named Clementine? So I'm gonna look up a list of popes really quick. Listing out these fucking popes, like I'm checking these facts like Snopes. I'm about to hit you, a no scope. Dooley's on the diggles, baby, a bloke, bloke. Okay, I'm fucking panicking, like I'm Pope Francising. I'm the shit, I'm hiding more secrets than Pope Benedict. Yeah! I'm bringing it all, like my name's fucking John Paul. I could be one or two, I'm number one pope, baby, for you. So fucking truthful that it's a religion. Every day I wake up and I make a decision. Why? It's for my head to be clear. Every time that I say that the truth is right here, just know that I mean it when I spit it so fat. Yeah, man, can you handle that? Uh-huh, it's the fucking truth. I'm Clementine, but I ain't no fruit. And by that, I mean that I'm not off the vine. I'm growing off a tree that's in your mind. The tree of fucking knowledge. Clementine, baby, and you'll never fucking stop it. Woo! Hitler escaped to Argentina? That's not even a conspiracy, baby. That's a fact. Another fucking fact. I don't care conspiracies. I say dark truths. And the darkest truth of all is that the truth has been right here. See you later. I'll probably be Australian or something. What's... Whoa, this is my real send-off, guys. I'm disappearing into the night. Bye!
All right, Clementine. Dropping those Limp Bizkit beats on his way out the door. He'll be back in the door. So it'll be a slightly different Clementine. Okay. Producer Dog, how are you doing?
What? I forgot that I was here.
You forgot that you were here?
Yeah, but I still am.
Okay. Well, we'll skip voting on you today, but just know that that will happen at some point.
Okay, well, I'm still waiting for Fiona to pick me up, so that's fine. I don't have anywhere to go till she does.
Yeah, exactly. Let's see who's on. Bum, bum, bum. Fiona's on. Perfect timing.
She's on? Can you tell her to come get me?
Okay, well, that could be our raid message. Just guys, let Fiona know that her dog is ready to be picked up.
Yeah, please let her know. I've been waiting for about a month plus a couple other months. So anytime, I mean, it's a nice studio and I got a bowl here, but I'm not trying to rush her. I'm just waiting.
Okay, fair enough. Can we get a push a T on a case wrap one day? And let's see if I save up enough. I can just be like, hey, Pusha, can I pay your rate? Come to a rap with me. It's a Fiona Nova time. So guys, my hope is to start pushing the start time of this stream down. I had a meeting today at 11, which stopped me from being able to stream then. But usually my meetings are later in the day. I'm hoping I can get on a more consistent schedule so that I can actually tell you with more confidence when I'm streaming. And I do feel like in the morning it might be easier on my day. But we'll see. I'm still kind of up in the air, but the hope is maybe eventually to stream more at like, maybe even like 9 or 10. But the goal was 11 a day. Anyway, tomorrow we'll see just how the day unfolds. But eventually I should be on a little bit more of a schedule. The hope with this Amazon job that I've taken, which is it's great, I love it, is that I don't have to take as many jobs because it pays pretty well. Oh, and then I can stream more regularly because I'm going to have to take Thursdays and probably Fridays off for a few weeks. Anyway, guys, enjoy your time with Fiona. Let her know that her dog is ready to be picked up, and we'll see you all tomorrow. Have a beautiful one. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.